إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، عمر ابن عبد العزيز رحمه الله تعالى، أي خليفة بالإسلام، the leader of the Muslims رحمه الله تعالى، would have a common trait, a trait that was found in the vast number of the righteous and pious that used to come before, but it's only found in a few that live in today's day and age. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz rahimahullah ta'ala would often plan and plot for the strategies of the Muslims under his khilafah. And as he would plan and plot and sit to his companions, looking to ways to be just for every single believer of Islam and to fight against the enemies of Allah Jalla wa'ala, he would often rahimahullah ta'ala contemplate and ponder. He would often daydream as he would plot and plan, as he was speaking, whilst he was discussing the affairs of the Muslims. He would look towards a distant area and suddenly he would collapse rahimahullah ta'ala. He would fall unconscious until when he was woken up, he was taken to his home. And some of his companions or his family members would ask him, "Oh Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, O Amir al-Mu'mineen, O leader of the believers, what causes you to reflect like this and ponder like this and suddenly fall unconscious? Suddenly as you're talking, as you're speaking, you look away, it seems as if though you're seeing something else from this world. And then you collapse. What is it, O leader of the believers?" He says, rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, he says, "I began pondering and thinking about the fire. I began pondering and thinking about the punishment that Allah Jalla wa Ala has stored and prepared for the disbelievers and the sinners in this dunya. How can I not fear Allah Jalla wa Ala? How can I not fall unconscious? How can I not prepare myself for a time whereby my hands will be shackled, my neck will be shackled, and I will face the punishment of Allah Jalla wa Ala?" Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, the same Khalifa of Islam, rahimahullah ta'ala, that whenever he recite the Quran, and every time he will come to an ayah whereby Allah Jalla wa Ala mentions a calamity, a punishment, a trial of the Akhirah, he would stop and he would cry until his beard would become drenched in his tears, and then he would repeat the verses from the very beginning until he would stop once more, unable to complete the recitation of the Quran, even when he was the Imam of the Muslims leading them in Salah. Imam al-Dhahibi rahimahullah ta'ala narrates that when Umar ibn Abdul Aziz rahimahullah ta'ala will lead the Muslims in prayer, and he will recite the surah وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى, and he will continue to recite until he will come to the ayah فَأَنْذَرْتُكُمْ نَارًا تَلَظَّى, and I warn you of the fire that will overcome and over and wrap the disbelievers and punish them severely. He will stop and he will cry until he will repeat the verses once more وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى, until the ayah of fire, until the ayah of punishment, and he will not be able to go beyond this ayah. The Salaf al-Salih, rahimahullah ta'ala, The pious and righteous generation that came before us, they used to have a common trait. And their trait was, oh believers in Islam, their trait was that they used to often ponder and contemplate about the punishment of the fire. They used to often remember Allah Jalla wa Ala and His punishment that He's prepared, that He's created, that He has subhanahu wa ta'ala warned the believers about. What you'd find in their hearts is fear. What you'd find in their hearts is fear of a reality. It's fear of something that is going to take place. And this is why they were where they were. And they reached the levels they reached. And they became who they became. And this is why, oh brothers, oh sisters in Islam, we are so far away from achieving the success that they achieved. For how often do we remember Allah Jalla wa Ala? How often do we remember the punishments of the fire? How often do we remember the fire in itself? How often do we actually talk and discuss about the different levels and manners in which Allah Jalla wa Ala punishes His slaves, punishes the disobedient ones, punishes the disbelievers, punishes the believers that take the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And thus today, inshallah ta'ala, I would like to take this khutbah in an opportunity to discuss some of the characteristics of the fire. Some of the characteristics of how Allah Jalla wa Ala will punish the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But first, oh brother, oh sister in Islam, let it be known to each and every single one of us that the greatest form of disgrace, the greatest form of humiliation, the greatest manner in which Allah dishonors and mocks His servants is by the fire in itself. There is no greater punishment from Allah Jalla wa Ala. There is no greater way of mocking and disgracing the servant of Allah Jalla wa Ala than the fire in itself. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, Rabbana, He says Jalla wa Ala, إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارِ فَقَدْ أَخْزَيْتَ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ. O Allah, O Lord, O Rabb, whoever enters into the fire, فَقَدْ أَخْزَيْتَ, then you have disgraced him, you have dishonored him, you have humiliated him, you have mocked him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ, and no one from the transgressors, no one from the ones who takes the rights of Allah Jalla wa Ala, none of these people that will be disgraced in this manner, none of them will be able to find a helper. The utmost, the epitome of disgrace, the epitome of dishonor, the epitome of humiliation is Allah Jalla wa Ala decreeing for the servant of Allah to face the fire. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, U'iddat lil-kafirin. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala that the fire has been prepared. It's been created. It was there before creation. Allah Jalla wa Ala created it. He subhanahu wa ta'ala made the fire. And He created it for who? He prepared it for the disbelievers. The scholars of Islam, they say, oh brother, oh sister in Islam, ponder about this effect, ponder about this point, and that the fire hasn't been prepared or created by the creation. It was prepared and created by the Creator, Allah Jalla wa Ala. And what He creates is created with perfection. What He creates is created with the utmost level of carrying out its existence, carrying out the reason for its existence. And that's when Allah created the fire for adab, when He created the fire for punishing, He created the fire with perfection for punishing. He created the fire in a manner whereby nothing can match, nothing can equal the way in which Allah created the fire to punish. Nothing can equal the levels of punishment of the fire in itself, except one. And that goes beyond. And that is the punishment of the Creator Himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Allah Jalla wa Ala is Al-Khaliq. He is the one who creates, and He's not the one who has been created. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, إن جهنم كانت مرصادا للطاغين مآبا لابثين فيها أحقابا لا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا إلا حميما وغساقا جزاء أو وفاقا. He says سبحانه وتعالى إن جهنم كانت مرصادا. Verily, truly, the hellfire is a place of ambush, is a place of torment, is a place whereby the punishment of Allah Jalla will be found. للطاغين مآبا, a dwelling place for every person that has transgressed the rights of Allah. لابثين فيها أحقابا, they will stay and remain in there, some of them forever, and some of them for a long and lengthy time. لا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا, they will never taste or never find in it any form of cold or any form of content, any form of peace. Nor will they find in it any form of drink, any form of a way to tranquil themselves or to give them some form of tranquility or peace at all. Illa hamima wa ghassaqa, except they'll find in it boiling water. Wa ghassaqa, and the pus that comes out of the bodies when Allah Jalla wa Ala punishes them, or the blood that comes out of the body as Allah Jalla wa Ala punishes the slaves of Allah, they'll only find this in the fire. Oh brothers, oh sisters in Islam, as Imam al-Tahawi rahimahullah ta'ala mentions, wal jannatu wal naru makhluqatan la tafnayan abada wa la tabidan fa inna Allah ta'ala خلق الجنة والنار قبل الخلق وخلق لهما أهلا فمن شاء منهم إلى الجنة فضلا منه ومن شاء منهم إلى النار عدلا منه. He says رحمه الله تعالى والجنة والنار مخلوقتان, and the Jannah and the Jahannam are two things that Allah جل وعلا created. They will never disappear, never will they ever disappear, but they've been created for the servants of Allah جل وعلا. He says, فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ خَلَقْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ خَلَقَ الْجَنَّةِ. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Jannah and created Nar before He created the creation. And He created Jannah for the people that He loves. And He created Jahannam for the people that He hates. He created Jannah for the people that He would honor, for the people that He would grant virtue towards. But He created Jahannam to dishonor. And He created Jahannam to disgrace. Oh brothers or sisters in Islam, ponder about this creation of Allah. It is vast. It is wide and outspread. It has many levels. It's been created to punish. And its ibadah for Allah Jalla wa Ala has granted an ibadah for the fire. The ibadah of the fire, the worship of the fire is to punish. The worship of the fire is to punish. The fire has sets. The fire, as we'll discuss later, the fire has sets. It will speak. It has given eyes. It's been given a neck. It's been given a tongue. And it will call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Yawm al-Qiyamah. When Allah Jalla wa Ala would decree for certain groups of people to be taken to the fire. And they'll be dragged on their faces, taken towards the fire. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, يوم نقول لجهنم هل امتلأت وتقول هل من مزيد. When the people are dragged on their faces towards the fire, and they shackled on Yawm al-Qiyamah, and the angels take them towards their final destination, and Allah Jalla wa Ala will address the fire and speak to it saying, O fire, are you full? O fire, are you full? And Allah Jalla wa Ala says that the fire will reply, and will reply by saying, وَتَقُولْ هَلْ مِنْ مَزِيدْ. Is there any more? Are there any more people? فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, in a hadith reported in Muslim, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, لا تزال جهنم يلقى فيها وتقول. Jahannam will find people being thrown into it, but it will continue to say, after every group of people, after groups of people are thrown in one after another, after another, after another, it will continue to say. Continue to say to Allah Jalla wa Ala, هل من مزيد؟ هل من مزيد؟ هل من مزيد؟ Repeating over and over, are there any more Allah? Are there any more Allah? Are there any more Allah? And repeat this over and over again for the ibadah. The ibadah, the worship of the fire is to punish the evil servants of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Just like how the slave of Allah, some of the Mufassirun mention, just like the slave of Allah find contentment in Salah, or they find contentment in Sadaqah, or they find contentment in Siyam, they find contentment, they find peace and tranquility in worshipping Allah. So the pious and righteous amongst us, we excel, they excel. They excel in their ibadah, they excel in their Salah, they excel in their Siyam, they excel in every different category of worship, because that is where they find contentment. The ibadah of the fire, as the Mufassirun they say, is to punish the servants of Allah. And the ibadah of the fire is to punish as many evil servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thus when Allah jalla wa ala decrees for groups of people to be sent into the fire is begging Allah. The fire is asking Allah for what? Asking Allah to find contentment in His worship. Is there anyone else that deserves my punishment? Is there anyone else that deserves punishment? هل من مزيد هل من مزيد. Every time a person enters, هل من مزيد هل من مزيد. Is there anyone other than this? Is there anyone other than this? Is there anyone else that I can destroy, that I can torment, that I can punish? The fire saying, فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, حتى يضع الرب, until Allah جل وعلا places on top of the fire قدمه, his foot, وفي رواية رجله, his leg, and he will tell the fire to calm down, and he says صلى الله عليه وسلم فينزوي بعضها إلى بعض, until parts of it will fold over other parts, and the fire will say قط قط, enough 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 enough, بعزتك وكرمك, by your might and by your blessings. Hadith reported in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, while speaking about the vastness and the greatness and the might of the fire in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, one day he was sitting in the hadith in Sahih Muslim with his companions, and they heard the sound of something reaching its floor, something that was thrown, and it made a noise as it hit the floor, as something that is thrown from a large area, from a high distance. When it touches the floor, it makes the sound of a bang. So the Sahaba, they heard the sound of a bang. So they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, Ya Rasulullah, what is this sound? Or he said to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, تَدْرُونَ مَا هَذَا, do you know what this sound is? And they said to him, Ya Rasulullah, tell us, what is this sound? And he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, هَذَا هَجَرٌ رُمْيَ بِهِ فِي النَّارِ مُنْذُ سَبْعِينَ خَرِيفًا. This was the sound of a stone that was thrown in the fire 70 years ago. In another riwayah, 70,000 years ago. And it's just reached the bottom of the fire now. And you've just heard the sound of the fire now. The same fire to whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, describing his vastness and describing his greatness and describing his might, he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when speaking about وَجِيَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ, when speaking about Allah Jalla wa Ala telling us that there are groups of angels that will bring the fire يوم القيامة, he says صلى الله عليه وسلم يُؤْتَى بِجَهَنَّمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَهَا سَبْعُونَ أَلْفَ زِمَامٍ. When the fire is brought in يوم القيامة, when the fire is brought so that entire humanity can see the fire, it will be brought to mankind with 70,000 chains, with 70,000 different ropes around the fire. And he says صلى الله عليه وسلم مع كل زمام 70,000 ملك يجرونها. And with every single chain, with every single rope that the fire is brought with on يوم القيامة for mankind to see, there are 70,000 angels holding every single rope. There are 70,000 angels holding every single rope as the fire burns, as it collapses, as it unfolds upon one another, as it torments itself from level upon level. And these malaika were trying to hold and control the fire. 70,000 angels holding every rope, 70,000 ropes. Imagine the vastness, the greatness of the fire. He tells us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the fire has darakat. It has levels, levels upon levels upon levels. And in each level you find different people, different groups of sinners being punished in different ways. In the munafiqeen, في الدرك الأسفل, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, من النار. أسفل المنافقين, أسفل the hypocrites. They'll be given, they'll be tormented by Allah Jalla wa ala in the lowest, lowest level. The lowest level of the fire. But in each and every single level, there is the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us. And there are some people, إِنَا مِنْهُمْ مَنْ تَأْخُذُ النَّارِ إِلَى كَعْبَيْهِ. There are some people to whom the fire will reach their ankles. Some people to whom the fire will reach their knees. Some people to whom the fire will reach their hips. Some people to whom the fire will reach their necks. And some people to whom the fire will engulf completely. And there are some people to whom will fear, to whom will feel the lowest level of punishment in the fire. And that is they'll be told to wear trainers or wear boots or wear shoes made out of fire that will make their brains boil. And they will think themselves that they're being punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the most severe level. Oh brothers, oh sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the fire. And He has spoken to us about the fire. And He has described these different levels and the different forms of punishment so that we can take heed. So that we can remind ourselves, like Imam Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah ta'ala, when he would sit down eating his food, or when he would pray his salah, or when he would be with his family at home with his wife or his children, his beard would become drenched in his tears. And his family or his companions or those in his gathering would ask him, why are you crying, O Imam, O leader of the Muslims, O scholar of Islam? And he would reply by saying, how can I not cry when I'm thinking, pondering about the punishment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for the slaves of Allah Jalla wa ala. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the punishment of the fire. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إن الله غفور. والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. Continuing inshallah ta'ala with some of the descriptions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us and informed us about in the Quran. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has elaborated and discussed slightly further to explain to us about the reality of the fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us an ayah in the Quran, to which Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala says, this is the ayah in which Allah Jalla wa ala speaks about a relief that some of the people of the fire will think they will have. But in reality, these are punishments from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Punishments upon punishments. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa ashabu shimal, ma ashabu shimal, fi samumin wa hamim, wa dhillin min yahmum, la baridu wa la karim. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa ashabu shimal, ma ashabu shimal. And as for the people that will carry or catch their scrolls in their left hands, then what is their affair? Who are these people? And what is their situation? He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, fi samumin wa hamim. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa dhillim min yahmum. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala and some of the other mufassirun, they say whenever Allah Jalla wa Ala punishes a servant, either in this dunya or in the akhirah, with severe heat, as we just experienced in these past few days, mankind, they seek contentment or they seek comfort or they seek assistance in one of three manners, in one of three ways. He says, rahimahullah ta'ala, either they look for something cool to drink, either they look for something cool to drink. Or he says, rahimahullah ta'ala, or they look for some air or some wind. Or they look for a shade to protect them from the heat of the sun. And this is the sunnah of mankind. Whenever Allah Jalla wa Ala decrees for us an extremely hot day, we seek comfort and contentment in one of these three ways. You look for something cool to drink, you look for an AC, you look for a fan, or you look for a shade. So he says in the Quran, as for ashabu shimal, ma ashabu shimal, as for the group that are going to catch their scrolls in their left hands, those that are going to be punished with Allah Jalla wa'ala, by Allah Jalla wa'ala, with the hellfire, they will look for one of these three ways. Fi samumin wa hamim. They look for some cool water. They look for some cool drink. They look for something to give them comfort in terms of liquid, in terms of water, something cool to drink, something cold to drink. What will they find? They'll find samum. And what is samum? Samum is a hot boiling water that will boil their intestines and boil everything that will touch inside of their bodies. Samum and Wahameen, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, they'll look for some kind of wind. They look for some kind of wind, and which wind will they find? They look for an AC, they look for a fan. But in fact Allah Jalla wa'ala will give them dukhan. Hamim is some kind of dukhan, a evil, disgusting type of smoke. Whenever a person inhales it, it will make him feel much more uncomfortable than before. And then he will look for shade. And what will he find in this shade? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says regarding him, وَظِلِّمْ يَحْمُومْ لَا بَارِدُ وَلَا كَرِيمْ. And when he will look for his shade, he will find shade in fires upon fire that will unfold above him and beyond him, covering him from every possible angle. Oh brothers, oh sisters in Islam, know that the fire of the hellfire and what Allah Jalla wa Ala has prepared for the evil servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those of us who sin and don't make tawbah to Allah, those of us who sin and don't regret our actions, those of us who sin and don't ponder and contemplate about the fact that we're going to be held accountable for these sins, and those of us that go beyond fulfilling or committing major sins or acts of shirk associating partners of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared and created and decreed a punishment in the form of the fire that is an absolute reality for each and every single one of us. It's been created for us already. It's been prepared for us already. And this is why in the qabr itself, in the grave itself, the person will be able to see his destination if he were to go to the fire or if he were to go to Jahannam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted the fire an ibadah. And the ibadah of the fire is to punish and to feel content in punishing, to feel tranquil in punishing. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says regarding the ibadah of the fire, he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith reported in Tirmidhi, and we concluded this hadith inshallah ta'ala. He says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَخْرُجُ عُنُقْ مِنَ النَّارِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. A neck from the fire would come out of the fire يوم القيامة. لَهُ عَيْنَانْ تُبْصِرَانْ. It has two eyes in which to look. وَأُذُنَانْ تَسْمَعَانْ. And two ears which will listen to. وَلِسَانْ يَنْتَقْ. And a tongue that will speak. يَقُولَ. It will say to Allah جل وعلا, oh Allah, I've been promised to punish the slave of Allah جل وعلا. I've been promised to punish three groups of people in particular. And he will mention, oh Allah, send to me every single tyrant, every single oppressor. Send to me every single person that associated parties with you. And send to me every single person that made pictures, or that made idols, or that created things. It will speak to Allah Jalla wa'ala with its tongue. It will look towards the creation. The scholars of hadith, they say, this hadith in itself tells us that the hellfire would scan and look towards every single part of Allah Jalla wa'ala's creation. It will look to us in the eyes, face to face, looking deep into our souls. It will either call you by name, or call you by your sin, or call you by saying, oh Allah, hal min mazid? Is there anyone else? And just like how the slave of Allah, he fears the wrath of his father, or he fears the wrath of someone over, someone with control over him, or has power over him, in the sense that he fears not to look at them eye to eye. During times of punishment, or during times of trial, at that moment, O slave of Allah, at the moment, O slave of Allah, the scholars of Islam, they say, the servants of Allah will fear looking eye to eye with the fire. For the fire will reach out of his neck and look towards, scanning every single part of creation, eye to eye, face to face, calling Allah Jalla wa Ala to punish the evil or the sinning servants of Allah. It is a matter to be afraid. It is a matter to fear. It is a matter that is the absolute reality. It is a servant of Allah that will punish the slaves of Allah Jalla wa Ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma ajirna min al-nar. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the fire. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the people of the enter Jannah. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from every punishment of the dunya and the akhirah, of the grave of the yawm al-qiyamah, of the fire and every single test or calamity that He has created Jalla wa Ala. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal-Muslimin. Allahumma adhill al-shirk wal-mushrikeen. اللهم إنك عفو تحب الأفو فاعف عنا. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. قوموا للصلاة.